Hi everyone, my name is Anka. I'm an Agile coach and I work with multiple machine learning teams which had different setups. And across the years, I noticed that there are some things that are very particular to machine learning projects or machine learning teams. And when it comes to applying Agile to this kind of environment, we have some particularities. And across the years, I developed some best practices that I'm going to share with you so you can get started using Agile and get the most out of it while being a data science team. So let's get started. First thing first, we need to look on the machine learning project, product, however you want to call it, and to understand what it's made of. Usually we have data collection, we are exploring the data so we can understand what we can do out of it. Then we may find some algorithms to apply, but we don't know which one performs better in our given circumstances. And then once we identify it, we go to retraining and we adjust the algorithms, and then hopefully we are going to have an amazing, outstanding, innovative product that is going to go live on the market. For Agile to work and you to be able to have the support needed to go incrementally and to make the most out of it, we need to make sure that everyone understands it. We need to start to decompose the process. We need to bring this rocket science into something more digestible. So we have data, which is exploration. We have then the research part, trying the algorithms. Then we have a part that we know the moment where we hit it, we know it, it's working. We just have to go and improve it and improving it. And it's getting very repetitive. That's a part that we can predict. So what I always advise the teams that I work with to do is to separate the unknown part and the known part. The known part is going to be our classic user stories. But when you look at it, at the work that you do as a data scientist, you realize that most of the things that you do are unknowns. For the whole Agile concept to work, you need to intercalate all these three. You are going to have sprints in which you are looking at the data. You have a time box and you investigate the data. If you are confident to that data, then you next sprint, you can go ahead and implement and commit for an algorithm improvement. If you found an algorithm, then again, next sprint, you can go ahead and commit to a deliverable. But if you don't have anything, how you are going to commit? One of the issues that brings a lot of stress inside the data scientist team is that we don't know how the data looks like, we don't have yet an algorithm, but the shareholders expect us at the end of the sprint to have a delivered model that is ready to go in production. And eventually we start to think how thin you can make these layers in order to work. I can tell you that across the years, we try to make it very thin, like to have very little data with a very basic algorithm and to see improvement. It doesn't really work. That's why I recommend you split the three into three different sprints. When it comes to data exploration, that's mostly a time box. You don't know how long it's going to take. Most of the time, you just look for what open source data are available out there. Do we have any proprietary data? How this data looks like? And these are all questions that we have and that we want to answer. When we are dealing with such kind of actions, we call them spikes. Spikes are time boxes used to research a certain topic. And who best in researching topics than you as a data scientist? If you want to learn more about spikes, check out the other video. I have a full video made on what are spikes, how to use them, and how to make the most out of it. Then the algorithm exploration, that's also a part of a spike. And to be honest, sometimes I mix the spikes depending on what is the algorithm that we are looking for. Sometimes it can be part of our refinement process that we have a spike to research and to try the algorithms And then in the refinement process, we are deciding which algorithm to go for depending on the findings that we have. However, this is also something that you as a data scientist team, you cannot commit to. You have no idea what you are going to find. So why to commit for it? Why to disappoint? We are going to call it a spike. Then once you found you have the right data, you have the right algorithm, that's kind of straightforward. You know that no matter what, you are going to have an improvement. How big this improvement will be, we don't really know. However, if you are doing multiple retraining and multiple improvements, I do recommend you are tracking data of your improvements because these are going to help the decision makers to prioritize. Now we learned that we have spikes for data exploration, for algorithm trials, and we have user stories for the actual improvement of our data models. Of course, there is more to it, and I'm going to make more video of other topics when it comes to agile and data science teams. But this is something that I want you to start practicing, decomposing your work into these two kind of spikes and the user stories. And once you start master it, let me know how it goes and what are your findings. And subscribe to this channel and click on the bell button to get notifications every time I'm releasing a new video. You may wonder, oh, hold on, I'm having two spikes, I'm losing half of my sprint with these two things, and I'm only doing very few story points compared to my colleagues who have a lot more story points. Now, here is the trick. As you get better at it, you are going to see how you can reshape these user stories to make them more user story kind of that you deliver value. The teams that I work with, sometimes they learn to split the process, this process among multiple kind of jobs. We have people who are specialized in gathering data and analyzing data, and then the data scientists only work on the part of algorithm optimizations. And this is actually great because now you get to see where you can be more agile, how you can become faster about the process. Maybe it's not just about how you split between user stories spikes, but it's also about how you find the right resources in the right place. To give you an example, one of the teams that I worked with, they managed to make the data acquisition and exploration a very straightforward job that anyone with the proper instructions will be able to do. And on top of that, they developed a tool that helped to get this data. So our data scientist team didn't have to take care of that because it was always correct. And that was a way of increasing the velocity. So try the three things and check out the other videos, subscribe to this channel, and you'll learn more tips about how you can become more agile, how you can do agile as a machine learning data scientist team.